Hey everyone, this is Pete here with BIMsmith, and today I want to go over Autodesk Material Libraries, where to find them, and how to put them in your project and put them to use. So let's take a look. So I'm going to head over to BIMsmith Market, where they actually just added a new feature to help you filter by material library only. So I'm going to click on that. And once that pops up, I'm going to scroll down. It looks like there's a bunch of different material libraries I can choose from various manufacturers. So I'm not going to keep scrolling. I'm actually just going to make it easier on myself and search for something. Let's look at paints, specifically PPG. And here we go. A bunch of paint material libraries listed out for me, but even more specifically, I'd like to find an interior paint. So I'm going to type that in the search bar at the top. So I'm going to click on one and take a look. So it looks like there's an icon to show me that as a deliverable when I download this file, I will be receiving a material library. I want to compare a few of these before I actually commit to downloading something. So I'm going to use BIMsmith's compare tool, and I'm looking for a flat paint. And let's say I don't want any VOCs in it, so I'm going to look at that, and it looks like it narrows down to the one on the right here. So let's go ahead and download that. So once downloaded, I'm going to go ahead and click on the zip file and extract its data. Once extracted, I'm actually going to just make sure I got what I was looking for. And sure enough, there's an ADSKLIB file, which is an Autodesk library file. Now I'm going to head over to Revit, and we're going to open that up. So I've just created a quick project with four walls and a floor, just to show you how you can import this library and then use it. So let's go to our materials. As you can see, all the standard materials are in here, but I want to reference that library that we just downloaded. So I'm going to click this icon here to bring up the material libraries. Here's the Autodesk one loaded in for you, but I'm going to add a new one. So I'm going to search for where I saved that. This one was in my downloads. Go ahead and open that file. And once open, I now have access to all of the paints that fell within that category that I downloaded on BIMsmith Market. I can go through here and scroll and find any particular paint that I was looking for within that product line and just go ahead and click the arrow icon on the right to add it to my project. Once complete, I can close the window for the material libraries and start applying these materials to system families or by painting them on the surface. I'm going to click and search for PPG. And there you go, there's the four materials that I added from the material library. I can just select the material I want, rotate around the view, and start painting surfaces. And there you go, simple as that. Now, what you could also do is, for example, if you downloaded a paint, you could apply it to the wall assembly itself and give it a thickness. That way you can actually tag it in section. So what I'm going to do is add a paint layer to this wall system that's already placed in the project. And then I'm going to apply a paint to that so then I could tag it later on from section. Each wall now has a layer of that paint on the surface. So if I use a material tag, not only can I apply the tag to the surface in the background, but I can apply it in section as well. So I can show you that by just placing a couple of material tags right here. And of course, these material tags could speak to any parameter within the material. Right now, they're talking to the description, as this is an out-of-the-box material tag in Revit. And so then you could begin to break up the descriptions and the annotations of your wall assembly. So there you go. We found a material library and applied it within our project. Thanks for watching, everyone, and tune in next time.